they are not happy.
So you're a songwriter, a performer, but also a producer for some pretty phenomenal artists.
Thank you.
Good evening, my friends. Thank you, thank you. What a crowd already! We could have used you this past week. No disrespect, but like, this is a whole nother level. Well, welcome. It's been a long time since I've been here. Thank you guys for being here. Thank you also. Well, a couple of things real quick before I launch into the... I'm going to talk to you all night, by the way, so... But I want to say how grateful I am after all these years of doing this for this whole tour to be sold out. Every show is sold out, and I'm so grateful. About 5 or 7 seats right in the scene of no shows. We're like 40 minutes in. Anybody who wants to fill those seats, fill them up. I'm not going to be looking at this red fabric for the rest of the night. Damn. They missed the boat. They missed a couple of really fun songs that they could have used to have sex with their partner later. Snooze you lose, bro. Canberra, I have brought with you this incredible band. Give it up for Why Not Nonstop and the Kids. His dandelion head, but his other name is Jay Penn. He's going to be amazing. Okay, so here are a couple things before we get going with the rest of the show. This is 100% your party. We have spent the better part of the last 3 years adhering to rule after rule after rule. There are none of those tonight. Like this, I hear these announcements when I'm backstage getting ready to come out. I hear this, you know, stage number, no photographs with flash photography or no video recording can be. That's bullshit. Take as many. You can film the whole show, post it on YouTube tonight if you want. Although you and I both know you're never going to look at that video again. But feel free to do whatever you want. You know, I don't understand that old no video like at a concert. Yeah. I got into this business because I wanted people's attention. Yeah. I wanted to take my picture. I put product in my hair and steamed out this jacket. Like, I'll take pictures, man. Okay, kind of anyone said he's, We're going to do an album that came out a few months ago called Songwriter, and we're going to do a couple songs from that album. We've already done one, the first song tonight, Believe in Me, was from the Songwriter album. We'll maybe do one or two more, maybe. But the bulk of the show is the hits. Throughout the night, if you feel like, as the show goes on, if you feel like, oh, he might not do that somewhere, feel free to yell it out, and if we don't have it planned, and I can somehow remember the lyrics, I will try it for you. But I know what you guys want. I'm the same way. If I go to a concert, I want to hear the songs I need. You know? Here I am in Australia, and I can't go see Harry Styles. He's in Australia too. Now, I love Harry Styles. And our schedules didn't line up for me to be able to go see the show. But I can tell you this, if I go see Harry Styles, and I pay for tickets and parking, and I schlep all the way out to the venue, he better fucking play as it was. We're gonna play as many of the hits for you as we can fit in. The other thing is the name progresses, not now necessarily, necessarily, but as the night progresses, I know it's a theater. I know it's me. It's not Metallica. It's me. But if you feel inclined to get up and dance, leave them alone, let them do whatever they want. So it's totally up to you. But I'm not going to lie to you. You guys are up here, of course, and you're jumping up and down. It makes me happier. So, but maybe later. You got to pace yourselves. We're not as young as we used to be. Back in the time machine for this one. Back to 1989. When I looked like this. I hear most of you cheering. But I also hear a few of you laughing. And there's nothing to laugh at, because that was cool as shit back then. This is called Angel Leah. Cheers. Love you guys. Thank you. Plus, I'm trying to get lit. Now that I have you in a good mood, I'm going to hit you with a newer song. Don't Run for the Exits. I think you'll like this song. So this was the single from the Songwriter album that came out a few months ago. And I'm very proud to say that this song in my home country went into the top 15 on the charts, which... Ladies and gentlemen, I'm 59. To have a song in the top 15 on a Billboard chart at 59 is fucking amazing! Grateful and extra excited about the fact that this song was a hit at home because I wrote this song with one of my sons. Yeah. I'm going to tell you more about one of my sons in a bit, but this is a song I wrote with my son Lucas, and I hope you guys like it. This is called Same Heartbreak. favorite part of the show. No disrespect to my band, who I love. But it's my favorite part of the show for a couple reasons. One, it's just you and me. The intimate moment with us together. How you doing? You guys good? You're a great fucking audience. Really great. Like, if you weren't, I just wouldn't say anything. I would just be like, okay, so our next song, but I'm telling you that you're great. We appreciate it. The other reason this is my favorite part of the show. Huh? Wait, I missed it. I love you too! I do, I love you too. I also feel the need to see other people, but... I guess I love you too, so... This is also my favorite part of the show, because I'm gonna do this song for you guys. And though I mentioned that I was going to tell you more about my sons, this is the part. So I have three sons. Some of you know this. I have three sons, the Marx brothers. True story. I had my first son, then my second son. And by the time I had my third son, I was great friends with John Farnham. And we were talking on the phone, and I said, we're gonna have another kid. And he said, can I just suggest a name? And I said, John? And he went, no, Skid. That motherfucker. Especially because of the tributes and the festivities this week, I want to raise a glass to my friend Olivia Newton-John as well. Oh man, that's a whole other story. I met Olivia when I was 19. And I had just started out in LA, and I was getting work as a background singer, and I got hired to sing background vocals on one of her records. And the way records work, when it comes to the background vocalists and the background vocal tracks, the artist is never there at the studio. They could care less. So the last thing I expected was to meet her. But I walked in the studio and there she was. And I had a heart attack. Because I've been in love with her, like the rest of the world, forever. And she was so sweet and kind, and then we became friends, and we were friends to the end. Like, to the end, we were friends. And you guys, what you think you know about her is true, but times a million. She was that sweet and kind. She would always, with everybody, not just me, but with everybody, she would always sign off on texts or Christmas cards or birthday cards. She would always sign, love and light, Libby. And that's what she was. She was love and light. And I'll never forget her. Okay, so back to my three sons, none of whom I named fucking Skid. So all three of my sons, I can tell you, are not only the most amazing human beings, like, they're just such good people. like they're my best friends, but they also happen to be really talented singers, songwriters, musicians. And when I wrote and recorded this song about a dozen years ago, they were, you know, late teens, early 20s, and I had a home studio, and so I recorded the song at home, and they were in and out of the studio a lot, and they all made a point to tell me that they really liked this particular song. And by that I mean, they would say to me, "I like that one." That's as excited as they got. Anybody who has kids here, you know, like, right? To get the faintest praise from any of your fucking spawn is like seeing a unicorn. So he's like, "Don't you really like it?" So, a little while back, I had this idea. They all three of my sons live near me in LA. So I called them up and I said, "You know, I'm going out on tour and I'm doing all these shows. I got an idea, but it'd be pretty cool if we went back in the studio together and re-recorded that song, only you guys play all the instruments," because my sons all play different instruments. So we did, found a studio, we went in, re-recorded the song, and I filmed them doing all their parts. So you're gonna see on video, my eldest son, Brandon, who's just turned 32, and I always throw up in my mouth while I go to the studio. I have a 32-year-old kid. But you'll see him playing guitar and singing harmony. And my middle son, Lucas, who co-wrote Same Heartbreak, Different Day, he's 30, he's playing piano and singing harmony. And my baby boy, Jesse, who's 29, is playing drums and singing harmony. And I'm gonna sing and play live to the video of my songs for you guys right now. This is called "When You Love Me." Thank you. so much. Mr. Jay Glenn is back to join us. There's a song from my second album is called Repeat Offender. And there's a song that I haven't played live in a long time, and I just felt like reinventing it a little bit. So we're gonna attempt this song with a very different arrangement. I hope you guys like this one. This was one of the hits from Repeat Offender. And it's called Too Late to Say Goodbye. I gotta have a little sip of this too. Hang on, I'm catching my breath. This is a... Oh, cha-cha-cha-cha, no. No, in fact, let me tell you a little story. Do you mind if I tell you stories and talk throughout the show? I hope you like it, because when I go to see singers I like, if they don't talk, I get pissed off. Like, I could just stay home and listen to the record. Like, if you're not gonna fucking talk to me and entertain me, what's the point? So, you just yelled cha-cha-cha. Here's why that can't happen with this. So this is actually gonna be the public service announcement portion. This is this stuff that I drink for my voice. And a couple nights ago, I thought, oh my God, I'm getting sick, I'm getting a cold. Because everybody around is, like, there's always stuff going around. It's really hard to stay healthy on the road. And if I get sick, then my voice gets fucked and then it's bad. So what I do to sort of preserve my voice on tour is I drink this stuff that I've been drinking for years now. And here's what it is. It's this much lemon juice, about this much heroin, I'm kidding, it's crack. No, it's like this much lemon juice and a little layer of crushed ginger, powdered ginger, which is really good for your voice, and some honey to sweeten it, and then a whole bunch of cayenne pepper. So, yeah, cheers. But it's so good for the... So here's the story. So, like, right before the pandemic, I get this text from Brian Adams. The great Brian Adams. Okay, now Brian Adams and I are not like besties. We don't hang out all the time or anything like that, but we've known each other for 30 years. And he's one of my favorite singers, great guy. And I get this text, I haven't heard from him in a while, so I was like, what? Brian Adams is texting me. And the text says, quote, "Dude, I'm in Milwaukee, Wisconsin. I've got a show in 4 hours, and my voice is gone. What's that shit you drink?" And I was so excited because I was going to hook him up. I'm like, I got you, Brian Adams. I got you, bro. So I gave him the recipe. It told me exactly what the measurements were and everything. And I said, okay, then you mix it together, you stir it up, you put it in the microwave for like 45 seconds, not too hot. Okay, so here's the thing. This same exact concoction is also used sometimes as a cleanse.
Wait!
The difference between using it as a cleanse or using it for your voice is for a cleanse, you drink it. Shot, 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 shot. But for your voice, you just sip it. And I forgot to tell Brian Adams. Ever since then. He's probably still in the toilet. Okay, so before the band joins us, or as the band is going to join us, I'm going to do two songs for you guys, back to back, that were both big hits for me, thanks to you. The first one was from my very first album back in 1911. And second one comes from the mid 90s. And All I ask, Canberra, all I ask is if you guys, if any of you guys know the words to either one of these songs, please, whatever you do, don't join in because you're just going to ruin it. Where did I get that joke? John Farnham.
Something that you lose by surprise.
11 years later, there I was doing my first tour of Australia, and we were in Melbourne. I brought my parents, And my parents, whenever they would come to a show, they never wanted to sit down here. They wanted to sit in the first row of the balcony because they could see, they wanted to see the audience. They wanted to like take in the whole thing. And my father, both of them are gone now. And my father said to me after the show, I was sitting there and the audience was singing along with every song. And I looked at your mother and I said, we're on the fucking other end of the planet. And they were singing, they're singing his songs and they were lighting up in the balcony. And just then, that song, I was looking up at you guys and I was thinking about my dad saying that. So, a beautiful moment. That kind of all emotional and shit. Alright, I'm gonna do one more love song here. But this is a song that I don't think you guys, I think you guys know this song, but up until tonight you might not know that I had anything to do with it. Because I didn't sing it. I didn't make it famous as a singer. I wrote it for NSYNC. They made it famous. And aside from just having a great time writing and producing this song for those guys, this song has become sort of like this wedding anthem. And I've had countless people, there are a couple of other songs of mine now forever, of course, but I've had people who come up to me and tell me that they've used this song for their wedding a lot. And now, because I'm kind of an asshole, when people come up to me and say, oh my God, it's so nice to meet you, we used your song at our wedding, I look at them and I go, should've known better. Come on, that's funny. They need this one. This is called This I Promise You.
Tears to your eyes.
Okay, so how about one more song that I think you'll know, but I didn't sing. But I wrote. One more? Because I'm very proud of, like, the songs I've written for myself, of course, but, like, the songs I've written songs with and for a lot of different artists over the years. Such an amazing thing to be able to, like, be in the room with these amazing people. And we're gonna do one more song. And I wrote this one with another Aussie named Keith Urban. Keith and I have written a few of his big hits, but this is my personal favorite. And I love how the band played it. This is called Long Hot Summer. Thank you so much, you guys. As we get a little closer to the end here, I want to take a minute, first of all, introduce the band one more time on the bass guitar, Mr. Llewellyn Hall. The great Jackie Burns on the drums. Yeah. And on the guitar, Mr. Jay Lynn. Here's a really cool little quick story before we do this song. So, I love playing with all these guys, but Jay and Why Not and I have been playing together now for about 8 years, 9 years. And we met just about a year or so before that. I went to see them. They were in a band that Jay formed called Harper Blinn. And I went to see them. They were opening for our friend Sarah Bareilles, the great Sarah Bareilles. And she said, you gotta come down to the show, but come down early because I want you to see this band that's opening for me. So I went out and watched them, and it was seriously like, not since U2 had I seen a band that blew me away like that. I loved every song. Jay was the lead singer and guitarist, and I was like, holy shit, I'm such a fan of this band. We got to hang out after the show. We exchanged numbers. A year later, we're making music together. So you like to have guys in my band who started out as like I was fanboying them, basically. And one of the songs that they played that night on that show is a song that Jay wrote that I love so much, and I always ask him to play it when we're together as a band. And I'm gonna just sit in on it for a verse, but this is Jay's song, and it's called Long Way From Home.
Friends are still walking all the streets at night. They ask me that question, where do I call home? I am shifting, I am shaking. Thank you.
this song all fucking night. Yeah. So I guess we'll do it for you. Yeah. I don't know why you're so obsessed with a song about a girl who got murdered in Nebraska, but here we go.
She loved to watch the sun.
never try out for the boys. You just weren't ready. I'm gonna give you another chance to grab one. Cause that was weak as shit. Can we do one more? Yeah. Just one more.
that's enough. It's not even my fucking song. Two.